Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on some of the most common BMW M30 engine problems. The M30 was produced from 1968 until 1995. There are quite a few different variants, ranging anywhere from 2.4 up to 3.4 liters. And ultimately, with that long production run from 1968 to 1995, it is actually BMW's longest running production engine of all time. Additionally, Ward's ranked the BMW M30 as one of the top engines of the 20th century. And that is part of the reason that the M30 had such a long production run. It was a very successful engine, a very simple, strong, and reliable engine, and all of that combined to make really an excellent engine in the BMW M30. Despite the fact that we're talking about some common problems with the engine here, the M30 really is an incredibly reliable engine even to this day. It is just old, and so a lot of the reliability issues and problems that pop up nowadays are simply age-related and wear and tear. Really is a stout engine design that does not have many common problems or really did not have any major design flaws even during its long production run. Anyway, with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss a few of the most common issues with the BMW M30. Number one on the list, we have the cooling system, and I just kind of clumped a few different issues into one category, and that's because this is really the weak point of the M30. And when I say weak point, I don't mean it was a complete disaster, but when things did go wrong, even when the M30 was a little bit newer, the cooling system tended to be one of the common failure points, and that includes the radiator, coolant expansion tank, the cooling fans, water pump, thermostat, and any coolant hoses. All of those parts were known to be problematic from time to time. Usually it wasn't something that the entire cooling system just continued failing and having issues, but all of these components were things that tended to have some earlier issues, say before 100, 120,000 miles. And that's especially true nowadays, just with the age of the BMW M30. The cooling system is going to be something that's going to need a little work and maintenance, especially if you're looking at picking up an M30 that maybe hasn't had that work done or doesn't have any maintenance history. Checking over that cooling system and replacing any parts that look old or worn is a good idea for the M30, just because, again, when it comes to the cooling system, still not even fully fair to consider it a common problem. But when things do go wrong with the M30, the cooling system is certainly towards the top of the list of the issues. Moving on to number two is head gasket failure. This isn't something that was due to any design flaws or really any issues with the cylinder head or the head gasket. Just as cars and engines age, head gasket is one of those things that tends to wear down and fail eventually. And that was very much and still is the case with the BMW M30. As these engines get up to 150,000 plus miles, especially considering they're 30 to about 56 years old now, head gasket failure is just something that can and does occur from time to time on the BMW M30. So ultimately, this is really just one of those things that is a age-related issue and something that 20, 30 years ago when the M30 was a bit of a newer engine, this isn't something that would have been fair to consider a common problem. One final note, when the gasket fails, it tends to be around cylinder number 6, so at the very back of the engine. Head gasket replacement is something that can be very time-consuming and costly if you end up at a repair shop, but fortunately, in the case of the BMW M30, it really is just an incredibly simple engine. There isn't a whole lot to it, and so it makes the M30 very easy to work on. Moving on to our third common problem, last but not least here, just wanted to discuss some other age-related reliability issues. Any rubber-like or plastic materials like gaskets, O-ring, seals, hoses, etc., all those kind of parts are just prone to degradation with age, mileage, and normal wear and tear on the parts. And so it is more common, just considering the age of these engines, if you pick up an M30 from a junkyard or maybe wherever you find an M30 or an M30 powered vehicle, if it hasn't been well maintained and kept up with, then chances are a lot of those parts are likely going to have issues. Again, unless it's been a well-maintained engine, these aren't really things that were common problems, but it is fair game to have some oil leaks or issues with any other components like that. So just kind of a final topic pointing out that, again, the M30 is an old engine and it is going to require a little bit of maintenance compared to a newer engine. So in summary of BMW M30 engine problems, there really really isn't a whole lot to talk about. Filming this video, say 30 years ago, would have been darn near impossible because it really is incredibly reliable and really didn't have any major design flaws or problems. The cooling system is one of those things that you could have argued because even when they were newer, they did have the occasional cooling system issues. But outside of the cooling system, there really weren't any design flaws. So the rest of the problems are really truly just age related. Now that's not saying that some other fluky random failures can't happen, but in the case of the M30, even to this day, a well-maintained M30 can be a very reliable engine. Again, it's BMW's longest running production engine of all time, and so that really goes to show how reliable and strong this engine really was, and that's a large part of the reason BMW kept it around for so long, having a 1968 engine design that they continued updating and improving and making different variants of all the way through 1995. When it comes to the M30, it's one of the most common engine swaps, especially for older BMWs in that 80s, 90s, early 2000s era. M30, especially the M30 B35, is a very popular swap for the strength, reliability, and ease of finding these M30 engines. So ultimately, when it comes to reliability, not really anything bad to say about the M30, and it is truly a great BMW engine and debatably one of BMW's best engines of all time. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.